Hello learners, welcome to NIO Studio. Today we are going to talk about electric charge. We will explain the basic properties of electric charge and will also explain the concept of quantization and conservation of charge. Now let us come to the definition of electric charge. Electric charge is nothing but the amount of energy or electrons that pass from one body to another by different modes. Now these modes can be conduction, induction, or any other specific method. Now electric charge is of two types, positive charge and negative charge. Charge is present in every type of body. All these bodies have no charge because they are neutrally charged ones. Neutrally charged means that they have equal amount of positive and negative charge in the neutral state. Symbolically, if we see, positive charge can be represented by a plus sign and negative charge is represented with a negative sign. Now let us see the structure of atom where the electrons, protons are present in an atom. This is the structure of atom. We see that in the nucleus we have two type of particles. One is proton, that is positively charged, and there is other is neutron, that is having no charge. And electrons are revolving around the nucleus in shells. So these electrons are negatively charged particles, and in an atom the amount of positive charge and negative charge is equal, positively charged atom. When the number of positive charge is greater than the number of negative charge, such as we can take the case of sodium here, sodium that is known as a cation, Na plus, and negatively charged atom, the number of negative charge is greater than number of positive charge. Here we can cite the example of chloride ion. So chlorine ion is represented with a Cl minus sign. Let us demonstrate the positive charge body and negative charge body through figures. Now this body has 5 units of positive charge and 2 units of negative charge. Positive charge plus 5 and negative charge minus 2. So net charge is, if we add them up, the net charge is plus 3. Units. Similarly, this is the example of a positively charged body. Now we will draw the figure for a negatively charged body. Now this body has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 units of negative charge minus 7 units. And the positive charge is plus 2 units. So net charge is minus 5 units. This is the example of a negatively charged body and this is the example of a positively charged body. A positively charged body has excess of positive charge and a negatively charged body has excess of negative charge. For an atom, only protons and electrons are responsible for the charge as the neutron has no charge. The protons are positively charged particles in an atom, electrons are negatively charged particles. Now symbolically we can represent the charge by the symbol small q. The standard unit of charge is coulomb. Let us come to the basic properties of electric charge. What are the basic properties of electric charge? We will discuss them one by one. Number one, the like charges repel each other. Then unlike charges attract each other. Third is, charge is conserved. And fourth is, charge is quantized. We shall take up them one by one. Now in this figure you see, one charge is positive, another charge is negative. So they will attract each other. And in the second portion, you see, we are having two positive charges and two negative charges. Two positive charges, there will be repulsion among them. Similarly, in between the two negative charges, they will also repel each other because they are like charges. Let us do this activity so you can see yourself. I am rubbing the comb with my hair and I have bits of paper in front of me. You can see the paper bits are being attracted by the charge comb. So this is charging by induction. Now we will explain the attraction and repulsion between like charges and unlike charges. This is a positively charged glass rod. This has been rubbed with silk and then it becomes positively charged. It is suspended by means of a support. Then we are bringing another positively charged glass rod near to this suspended glass rod, which is also positively charged. We see through this arrow that this suspended charge rod will move away from this glass rod, which we are bringing near. So when this is brought near, this suspended charge rod will move away this glass rod because both are having same charges. So it proves that the like charges repel each other. Now we will understand by means of a figure that unlike charges attract each other. Now come to this figure. We are having a positively charged glass rod here, which has been rubbed with silk and it becomes positively charged. Then we are bringing another rod. This rod is made of ebonite and it has been rubbed with wool. So it will become negatively charged. Now when this rod, ebonite rod, is brought near this glass rod, which is suspended, the glass rod moves towards the ebonite rod because both of these rods are having opposite charges. So this schematically represents that unlike charges are going to attract each other. Conservation of charge. Charge conservation is that the total number of total electric charge in an isolated system never changes. The net quantity of electric charge, that is the amount of positive charge minus the amount of negative charge, is always constant quantity. This is illustrated in this figure. Here you, in the yellow color, you can see that this is the duster and polythene strip is shown in a white color. So before rubbing, both were uncharged. The charge, the positive charge and the negative charge were equal on both the polythene strip and the duster. But when you rub the duster with the polythene strip, you can well see in figure that the positive charge is more and the negative charge is less. So we can say the duster is positively charged here. And the you can now see through the polythene strip. Polythene strip has more negative charge. The plus signs are very less and the negative signs you see are more in the polythene strip. So effectively we can say that the polythene strip is negatively charged. Now you take into account the total charge of the polythene strip and the duster. You add them up, the charge, net charge will be zero, as it was before the experiment, before the rubbing. This whole experiment can be summarized into 2 points, that the total charge of the system, duster plus polythene strip, is conserved. The second point is, it is neither created nor destroyed. It is only transferred from one body of the system to the other. When the duster is rubbed, the less tightly bound electrons from the duster are transferred to the polythene strip. The duster, now which is deficient in electrons, will become positively charged, and the polythene strip, which now has excess electrons, will become negatively charged. Now we will discuss the quantization of charge. The total charge on a body is always an integral multiple of small e, where small e is the charge on an electron. The charge on a body can never be like 2.5e or 1.5e or 1.3e. It has to be an integral multiple of small e. So mathematically we can say that if charge is q on the body and n is the number of electrons and e is the charge on one electron, so this can be written in the form of an equation, q is equal to n e, where n can take values from 0, plus minus 1, plus minus 2, plus minus 3 and so on. E is the charge on electron and it has a value of 1.6 into 10 raised to the power minus 19 coulomb. Today we have discussed the properties of electric charge in detail. Thank you.